This came out, I got, this actually, book came out before, but I just got my copy. Yeah, from Ronald Light, published this book. I guess it came out last year officially, but it took a while for me to get my hardbound copy of it, which just arrived this week. But yeah, so Ronald Light, he had contacted me back in 2017, early 2017, because he told me that he was doing this exposition, like an exhibit, at the San Francisco State University campus exhibit. But it was 2017, and he was going to do this thing. He gave me some synopsis. I forget what it was. He said, I'm going to do this thing about guitar pedals as like art and have like this art exhibition, but it's going to be all pedals. So I said, sure. I sent a brand new cream puff to him because that's what I was making at the time in 2017. I'd just come out with a new cream puff. So I sent one. It ran for like a year, maybe? It was a while. But like the next year, he sent the cream puff back to me. He said, oh, you know, I'm going to make a website, and he put up a website, which isn't up anymore. I kind of looked for it this week, but I didn't find it. And then he said, well, I'm also going to publish a book. And so, was it now, 5 years later? But yeah, so this is the book. Yeah, so this was the thing. Is this going to be overexposed? Okay. Yes, that's them putting together the exhibition and a little drawing of the cases. So they had the... the pedals in display cases. So it's the back of the book. This is like the panorama shot of the whole thing. Come on. Yeah, so. So, yeah, it was like, you know, they had them in these, like, big cases. And it'll right up on the cream puff there. You can freeze frame that later. he does give me credit on this page for doing the New York City Big Muff, although I didn't get credit on the Big Muff page. I think that's a political thing. It's just, you know, all pedals, like, a lot of them I'd never heard of because and they have pictures in there of the various exhibits. Oh, come on, there you go. Like, does it, you know. Ones with the fuzz tones, and here's another one where you could play pedals. They had a little upside down and backwards here. Yeah, there. They had like a little amplifier there, and you could emulate effects, and so it was interactive. Oh yeah, here we go. See, the pedals are in those custom display cases. It's pretty cool, you know. And there were some pedals I hadn't heard of. They're small batch type things, you know. I thought that was pretty cool. A number of them with analog meters and stuff in them, you know. And, of course, the usual fare. Yeah, my Big Muff there. Didn't get credit in the Big Muff section, but that's... not unexpected. I'm sure there were stipulations for that company to contribute. If you can buy it without buying it on Amazon, do that. Amazon's killing the book selling. But yeah, okay. Pedal culture, it's the only art exhibition I'm aware of that was all about guitar pedals. Now, a book.
dessert. In my lab, it's where I work. Yeah.